They stand y'all in a hurry, so we'll just do it quickie. Frankly, I have to qualify my remarks by stating that I have not seen the administration's bill. I've only been told about it. I do understand that it is the intent of that legislation not necessarily to give more freedom to legal services and attorneys, but to insulate the attorney-client relationship from outside interference. And certainly we would welcome that.
Why do you feel that there is an interference between your relationship with your client at this time?
Generally, we see the kind of interference we see is in the form of political pressures being brought to bear on elected representatives such as Congressman Collins and Congressman Cabell when we file lawsuits on behalf of poor persons against governmental agencies such as the Department of Agriculture, Department of Labor, the local housing authority, the county welfare board. This often results in pressures being brought to bear to influence the course and scope of the litigation we get involved in.
Absolutely not. The American banks are safe. They're safer than any other bank. Money in American banks is perfectly safe. Under cover of this inflation, as I explained in my book, What Shall I Do With My Money? Product prices are being beaten down here in America. The consumer is beating business to its knees. Cash is worth a premium. Cash is worth a bargain. The only place where cash can't get bargains up to this point, this year, is the stock market. If I'm right in my expectations and the European to-do about the dollar today, I think guarantees that I'll be right sooner than even I expected. I hadn't really expected it till the summer. A break in stock prices will mean that those with cash will get bargains in stocks too.
Speaker Mutcher has agreed to move to concur in Senate amendments to the House tax bill tomorrow morning. I predict that the House will, by a majority vote, pass the tax bill. I think the major financial problems of the Texas legislature in 1971 are solved, and I think this is the major hurdle that has been cleared out of our way. I think we're going to get our work done. I don't think there's going to be a special session in Texas in 71.
You then think that redistricting can be handled during the next few weeks?
We've got 3 weeks to handle redistricting, and I'm very confident that the legislature can do this. We've already done a lot of preliminary work. We're going to start on congressional redistricting next week.
Now, I think the thing that stunned us most in the news today was to be brought face to face with the fact that the dollar is in trouble as a unit of currency, as a unit of exchange, because in my life, most of that time of my life, the dollar has been the most stable monetary unit in the world, and the currencies of the rest of the world would look to the dollar as the most stable thing. But in discussing responsibility for this, I think we ought to remember the real root cause of why the dollar is in trouble. It's in trouble because we fought a war in Southeast Asia for 10 years that cost us about $125 billion. And Europe and Japan were smart enough to stay out of it. And say at the peak, Europe was never as rich in its history as it is now. Japan was never as rich in its history as it is now. The communists don't want to settle this war, in my opinion, because they see America pulling its currency down. The proud dollar's in trouble. We've sucked in over there, and we haven't had the will to get, or the intelligence to get out.
This is a point of where I don't think you stop to think, except you know that you've got to act, and you're the only link of life that these people have if this is the case. So consequently, you proceed on into this situation, governed by the fact of experience that you know how much you can go or how far you can go or what you can do before you're endangered.
Well, you went in the building not once but twice.
Yes, sir.
What did you think about when you went back in that second time? You know how bad it was the first.
At that time, I was wondering if I could find the other person or if I could hold out that long.
But you did.
Luckily.
Would you do it again?
I'll do it at any time if the situation warrants it.
We have had to slow down a program for economic reasons, of course. Economic reasons that have pretty much affected the whole country. But Apollo 15 is going up in July on a much more sophisticated, much greater scientific return type of mission than Apollo 14, on a lunar flight, that is. And then Apollo 17 will follow in March, or 16 will follow in March, and 17 the following December. Then we've got programmed yet the space laboratory, Skylab, the orbiting laboratory, and should start flying in 73. And right now we're in the process of developing, because it takes 6, 8, 10 years to develop this sort of thing. But more of the ultimate type of booster spacecraft, the reusable booster, a reusable spacecraft called the shuttle. You know, creativeness, scientifically, artistically, in other ways, are generally fostered by wars. A war begins, Japanese bomb Pearl Harbor, and the development of an airplane is normally 4 or 5 years. It's done in 1 year or 18 months. But the space program has been able, through the challenge that it presents to the American people, through the challenge it presents to the world, has been able to stimulate this creativeness, stimulate the imagination of people to progress ahead rapidly without the destruction of wars, without killing millions of people and destroying millions of cities. I think that's another aspect of the space program which people are beginning to appreciate more and more all the time.